In our business here at Irving Oil, Canaport, and the way we bring crude in is a very important factor, obviously, to our facility. So access to reasonably priced crudes, logistically competitive and reliable, from reliable sources is very important to Irving Oil. Has been since the day we opened the refinery and will continue to be. This just gives us another option. Through TransCanada's pipeline in through to Canaport, we'll have the option to access, you know, a certain percentage of that volume with a lot of potential to increase that volume over time. So it just brings optionality to our crude slate, which is very important, and from a very reliable source in terms of, you know, national security and things like that. So it's a great option for us. You know, depending on what crudes are being shipped and what the demand is in the market, it certainly has an option to make up a large percentage of the crude that we run at this refinery. In the short term, the optionality it brings in terms of future investments, you know, we know for sure that if it doesn't occur, business will carry on as it is today, which is very competitive in the waterborne crude world. But this just opens up a lot of opportunities once it's built in terms of what our future possibilities are as a facility here in St. John. Business attracts business, success attracts success. If the pipeline comes into fruition and we're able to expand on that and look at different options in our facility, who knows what other synergies could be developed around that as other spin-off businesses in terms of petrochemical, etc. You know, it's premature to get too far ahead of ourselves on those, but the reality is, unless it's built and unless that infrastructure is there, these other potential things don't have the capability of happening.